I just need some time, I'm trying to think straight. I just need a moment in my own space. Ask me how I'm doing, I say okay. Yeah, but ain't that what we all say?
Yo, what it do? It's your boy MTZ King, and I'm back on your screen. Man, I just got out the shower because I just woke up right now at 12. It's late. It's 12:32 and I already woke up right now like at 12 and I took a shower. And because I couldn't sleep last night, so I fell asleep till like right now, really by like 6 o'clock a.m. And it's so crazy because, alright, I was watching TV for a little bit. I was watching George Lopez around like 2, 3 in the morning. But then it finished, I turned it off. But at that time, I was jamming out to Ariana Grande. Like, I was listening to all her songs. And so as I fell asleep with my Beats on, listening to her music. I had her music playing or whatever. Tell me, why the fuck was your boy dreaming with Ariana Grande? And when I mean dreaming, I mean I was dreaming. I was like, what the? But you know when you have a dream and it just feels like so real? That's exactly how this dream felt. I'm just like, what? Shit. I was in shock, you know what I'm saying? I'm just like, what? Like, damn, that's crazy. Hey, you know, like they say, some dreams do come true. But yeah, so now I'm just right here. I freshly got out the shower. As y'all can see, my hair is growing. I really want to cut it from the sides, but I still can't. And today I'm wearing my shirt that says "Ready to Win." Yeah. I actually got this shirt before my dad went into surgery, and I wore it the day that he had surgery because my dad has had colon cancer, and today makes 3 years since we found out that he had it. Today makes 3 years since we found out that he had it. And on the 7th, on March the 7th, we'll make 3 years since he had surgery. And on the 14th will be the day they released him from the hospital. But that's why I got this shirt. It says "Ready to Win." And it got the cancer ribbon with the boxing glove, as you can see. But anyways, though, I'll see y'all in a bit. I'm about to take my medication right now and probably end up going back to bed because I'm tired. Like I said, I fell asleep till 6 in the morning. But anyways, though, I'll see y'all in a bit, though. Chill. So what to do, fam? I'm back. Apologize. There's gonna be a part that y'all see on here. Oh my god, this damn stand. I need to get a new damn stand, real talk. My bad. There's gonna be a part that y'all see in the video where like I'm in the car or whatever, and I was actually with my parents. Hold on real fast, guys. My bad, my stand just, I need to buy another one because that one, the grip ain't gripping no more. It's a small little stand that I have. I need to buy a tripod though. But anyways, so, like I was saying, there's going to be a part where y'all see that I'm in the car or whatever. And I was actually with my mom and my dad. We were going to the store real quick. And, they went ahead and took me since I've just been in the house and stuff. And I went out yesterday, but the only place I went to yesterday was to church. After that, I was just home. So since I had been laying down a lot and stuff, they took me out. Like I said, you know, it's to prevent from me getting blood clots and stuff. So we went to the store and stuff because my mom, she wanted to go buy a new shower curtain. And as y'all can tell, I got a fresh haircut. I finally cut my hair, you know what I'm saying? I didn't cut the top off. I just cut the sides. It was a challenge for me. And yes, I'm wearing blue. I got, you know what I'm saying? I'm kind of slacking. I just wanted y'all to see my haircut. But you know what I'm saying? I got got my blue shorts on, my basketball shorts on. I have my shirt on earlier, like I said. I think I did say why I had it on, you know what I'm saying? But right now I just finished eating. I finished eating some pozole. My dad made pozole. He made rice. He made he made some kind of like taco meats for tacos, and I don't know what else he made. He made a lot of stuff, but I just ate a little bit of pozole because I was already kind of feeling full because I've been drinking a lot of water, and right now like my low blood pressure is freaking low right now, so that's the only reason why I'm drinking Coke. I really, really been cutting off of Coke, and the only way I would drink Coke is if I know that my blood pressure is low. So my blood pressure was a little low, so it won't be so low. So that's why I'm drinking Dr. Pepper. Dr. Pepper makes the world taste better. Ah, look at the ass. But anyway, so that's all I've been doing. I went to the stores with my parents. We went to the store, and I did get a new outfit. I got a new gear, man. Y'all be seeing it soon. You know what I'm saying? Of course, I got a Steph Curry, another Steph Curry shirt, and then I got the shorts, like to go with it, whatever. But the shorts are not, they're from Under Armour, which y'all know Steph Curry actually collabs with Under Armour. They're on some Under Armour shorts, and I got the shirt, whatever. But my goal is to get a Steph Curry jersey. That's my goal, and because that's actually what I want to wear for my birthday. And because the cake that I want to get is actually, it might possibly be this jersey of Steph Curry, because you know how he's number 30 and I'm about to be 30. So yeah, that's the cake that I want. I wanted two cakes. I want one of a lion, and I want the Steph Curry jersey. And it's funny because when I turned, was it 20? I think it was 27. When I turned 27, I believe 27, 26. I think I turned 27. I actually had to go to State Warrior a cake, but this time I wanted to be a Stephen Curry's jersey, number 30. But yeah, anyway, so I think my brother just left, because one of my brothers was over. He came earlier, and then he just came right now. And I think he just left because I heard the door shut. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? I haven't got my... Oh shit, hold on. I'm saying, got my Golden State Warrior ball. You know what I'm saying? I can't wait to get better so I can go play some b-ball. Fun fact, when I was a kid, I used to love playing basketball. Me and my cousins were always, because I used to live in some apartments, and then across the street there was a church, and man, like every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, my cousins would spend the night at our house, and we were always at the church playing basketball. We would go like in the morning when we would wake up, then we would go like in the around the afternoon, and then we would be there at nighttime because they had lights, so we would be there at nighttime just playing basketball. And we would take like our radios and shit and connect it in, because it had an outlet, and we'd be jamming. And then now we would even go like to the park down the street, to Cole Park, for those of you that are familiar with Dallas. If you know where Cole Park's at, that's where we used to be at, playing basketball and stuff. We would always find a park to play basketball, trust me. That was us. We were always playing basketball. When I be telling people, they're like, why you used to play basketball? Like, man, shit. Man, if y'all could ask my coach from elementary, I don't even know if he's still alive or not, but man, I was the best player he had. He would always brag about me, and I would always be like, because he was so crazy, he would always be like, man, you're so short, but you know, you got them throws, you got them hoops. And I'm just like, hey, you know, sometimes size don't matter. It's like, you know, fun fact about Steph Curry, you know, they said that he wouldn't make it, and that boy is the best shit, best three-pointer in the damn NBA, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit, height don't matter. Don't never let nobody tell you anything about your height, whether if you're short or whether if you're tall, but more if you're short, because short people always get discriminated. My bad, y'all, I'm back. I was on the phone. Shit, I was getting emotional just by hearing, I'm telling y'all, I just been hearing Ariana Grande song. And then that shit hits me hard, because it just makes me realize and think about, like, my life. And it's like, just think about it and think about, like, somebody that you really love, whoever it may be, and imagine you got them one here 1 minute and the next day they're gone. It's just like, damn. And what hurts is, like, all the videos that I've been seeing is with her and Mac Miller. And it's like, man, like, I know she loved that dude deep down inside, because if she wouldn't, she would have still been with Pete Davidson, whatever his name was. By the end of the day, you know, she was with Mac Miller for 3 years, and imagine all the times they shared together, living together, you know, when all that shit happened in Manchester, you know, he was there with her. And then all of a sudden, it's just like, you know, shit happened, and that shit's sad. Like, you know, when I think about it, it's just like, damn, like, seeing the videos, hearing the song, it's just like, fuck, like, nobody ever wants to lose somebody that, like, well, basically, I see it more like a relationship. I wouldn't want to lose anybody, you know, because I done lost a whole bunch of family, a whole bunch of people that I cared about. And imagine losing, like, your partner. Like, that shit's fucking crazy. It's like, it's somebody that you're, like, attached to, and somebody that you do everything with, like, spend your life with, and for all of a sudden that person just to be ripped away from you. It's just like, damn. And I'm telling you, man, this song, listen to it, it's on her Sweetener album. It's called Ghost, Ghosting. And man, that was that one, and the other one that's gonna be inserted in my other clip, Breathing. I think it is Breathing that I did, or one of them. Yeah, I'm gonna insert it in the beginning of this one. But man, them two songs right there, them songs hit, like, they hit deep. I could relate to them songs, and I'm just like, it just makes you think about life and about the ones you love, because one day we're here, and then in the blink of an eye you could be gone. And it sucks. Like, I just been, like, literally right now, I'm about to just, you know, after I finish, you know, editing it for y'all, I'm just gonna, you know, lay down and jam out to these songs, so that I probably won't even be able to go to sleep, even though I take my medication for pain. But yeah, I gotta take it right now already, but it don't even, sometimes it puts me to sleep and sometimes it don't. And then right now, since I am in pain, though, I've only been taking it if I feel like really be like that and I need it, otherwise I haven't really been taking them. But man, these songs just going like, right. And then it's like seeing the video where she's talking. I had already seen this video like last year, I believe she made it, and we're like, she's actually crying, and it's just like. But it's like, man, out of everything bad, you know, she's just going nowhere but up. She's just going to the top, you know. And I might not know her like that, but I could say I'm proud of her, even though I don't know her. I hope one day I do get to know her and meet her and could be able to tell her, you know, face to face, that I'm proud of her. That's something that I actually told Becky G when I met her. I actually met Becky G. I have a video somewhere way back. I think I posted it like in November or December. I have a picture where I actually met Becky G. And I got to meet her. I got to hug her. And I told her I was proud of her. And now as I look at her, she's just skyrocketing, you know? She's even, she made a song with Kane Brown. Who would have thought she would have made a song with a country singer, you know? She's doing, you know, she's working with, you know, all these other, you know, big artists and stuff. And now she's working on her English album now. And it's like, man, she's going nowhere but up. It was her birthday yesterday. She couldn't even really spend it with, like, her boyfriend. Or, you know, she just got to spend it. I think her family, they surprised her with the cake. But I don't know if it was a day before or what. But her mom did post it on her mom's page. And, you know, being a singer, being an athlete, sometimes being somebody famous, you don't always get to spend the moments with your family. But your family becomes your family, your dancers, your managers. And the good thing, her dad is her manager. And, like, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, you know, Ariana Grande, it's just like, damn, it's like all she really got is her brother, her nana, which is her grandma, and, you know, her mom. Because they never really say anything about her dad. And it's like I could, you know, I know she's hurting, because, you know, like she said it herself, you know, Mac Miller wasn't just her boyfriend, he was, like, that was her best friend. And now people are saying all this stuff that, you know, she's going back with, they're supposed she's back with Big Sean, but I could be wrong, they could be back together, but I don't think they're back together, because my theory is they're working on music together. Because Big Sean, actually, if y'all didn't know, he was really close, good friends with Mac Miller. And that was the crazy part. That when Ariana Grande and Mac Miller were dating, Big Sean would chill with them. Because Mac Miller and Big Sean were actually best friends or something like that. So who knows, they're probably working on a song to dedicate to him. Even though Ariana Grande's been doing her own thing, you know, Big Sean probably decided, like, hey, you know, let's do one, you know, let's do one for him. And they're probably doing the duet together, but people are just assuming shit because she was in his car and supposedly they were cuddling. I didn't see no cuddling, obviously, in the video, because he was literally like this driving and she's like sitting there with the dog. So I don't know where the hell they got cuddling from, but, you know, paparazzis, TMC, they will fucking half of the time make up bullshit just to make up bullshit. Sometimes they're right, sometimes they're wrong. Who knows? I don't know, you know. But if she is back with him, that, you know, that's cool. But at the end of the day, she's only human, man. She's young. She's only 25, gonna be 26. Like, she's young, you know what I'm saying? Let her live her life, you know? This girl is one of the girls. She don't even have to sing no more. Like, that's how rich she is. She could stop singing. She could stop acting. She has money for the rest of until the day that she dies. She's one of the most youngest artists that she could retire and not do anything no more, because she'll be rich. She's fucking filthy rich like that. That girl started doing theater when she was 7 years old, and she's already 25, about to be 26. This girl literally could retire from singing and acting and everything, and she'll be rich. Why? Because she got her own merch. She got clothing line for people that didn't know. She has, like, a thing. She has her own perfume. Like, she could literally just have that, still get money off of that. And she has more than millions of dollars. Like, that's how rich she is. She has two homes. She has one in New York, and then she has one in Los Angeles. And I think she has one, in Florida, because that's where she's from Florida. So basically this girl has three homes. Like, what the hell? Ariana Grande, if you ever watch this video, get a home in Dallas. all jokes aside, but not for real though. Like, I don't care what anybody says about her, like, you know, she's literally one of a kind. Like I said, her voice is amazing, her music is amazing, her acting skills are amazing, she's just amazing. God blessed her with a most amazing talent, a most amazing voice. And I'm truly freaking sad from the bottom of my heart that I'm not gonna be able to go see her, only because all this happened and like all my money is going towards bills right now. That it sucks that I'm not gonna be able to go see her. My heart truly is freaking broken. Like, literally, if I have to go stand outside of American Airlines just to go stand, I would probably do that. But I am truly sad. But you know, everything happens for a reason. And I got to see, I was blessed to see her in 2017. My girl had bought me tickets to go see me. That's what she had gave me for my birthday. And I actually saw her 4 days after my birthday, because she came April the 9th of 2017. So I actually got to see her, and it was a pretty good view. But I was aiming to get VIP tickets this time around, but you know, it didn't get to happen. But you know, maybe later on in the future it will happen. But yeah, like I said, just be thankful for what you have, man, because there's a lot of people out there that don't got nothing and that are not fortunate and blessed. But like I say, you know, when you dream, dream big. Never give up on your dreams, no matter how old you are. Just do everything in your power, because your dreams are not just gonna come to you. You gotta do your part to make them come true. And just believe in yourself, man. And by you believing in yourself, anything is possible. Like I said, the word itself, never think of impossible, because the word itself has possible in it. So there ain't nothing that's put your mind to it, give it your all, and you could be whatever you want in this life, man. If you want to be a firefighter, if you want to be a singer, if you want to be an actor, you know, one story about Ariana Grande. The topic about Ariana Grande is so funny, because the first person that was gonna try to, you know, she wanted to do an R&B thing, they cut her off and were like, nah, you know, it's not gonna suit for you, it's not gonna fit in with you. Look at her now. Like I said, now she could fucking retire, and she has money. She's filthy rich. She has money until the day that she dies. That's how rich she is. But you know, you're gonna have people turn you down. It's the same thing with Becky G. Becky G, the first person, whatever, they turned her down. Record label, they turned her down. That's the same thing what happened to Ariana. But now look at both of them. They're both way up here. And I've been now. Then people that turn them down are feeling this. But like I said, now that people could turn you down, but I've been out and people that turn both of them down are feeling stupid, because now they went from being this low to being up here now, that they're, you know, having number one. They're having like on billboards from, you know, Ariana Grande has, I believe, 3 or 4 songs on billboards, you know, back to back. Because it's back to back to back to back, whatever, from all her albums that she's been dropping. It's the same thing with Becky G, and they both have had, you know, these record labels that turned them down because they didn't believe in them. But now look where they're at. So it's like, never think that you cannot accomplish your dream, because you're gonna have people turn you down, but then you're gonna have people that are actually gonna believe in you, and you know, they're gonna make you get to where you want to be. But never let anything turn you down or make you feel that you can't live your dream, because like I said, anything in life is possible. You just got to put your mind and put your heart, and you just got to keep your faith and your hope. And with that, and with believing in God, anything is possible. Your dreams could come true in a blink of an eye. But you're gonna eventually have people that are gonna turn you down and not believe in you, but at the end of the day, you're gonna leave them speechless and stupid, because they're gonna be like, man, I turned this person down, but oh my god, they're up here now. And that's exactly what happened to them. So y'all never, because I get that question a lot, like, you know, do you ever, you know, stop dreaming. Like, nah, I don't stop dreaming. I keep on pushing. I keep on grinding and trying to get to where I want to be and where I know I could be. And I've been doing music. A lot of people ask me, since when did I start doing music? I started actually writing my own songs and stuff when I was like in third grade. I still got all of them in a notebook. As soon as I get better from surgery, I could pull that notebook out to y'all and show y'all. But I've been doing music, doing my own music, and y'all ask, how do I do my music? I do it with one phone towards with the other phone, because I do not have the appropriate, you know, things. Like I said, I'm not rich, I'm not poor, I'm in the middle, but you know what I'm saying, at least I still get music out. Just like with my vlogs, I use my phone. A lot of people always say this and this and that, and I use my phone. You could never, if you want to be a vlogger, you could just pick up your phone and start vlogging. You got the editing program on there, whether you got Samsung or Apple. And so never think that you can't do anything. You could do anything you want in this world. My bad, that was my mom who I came in here. That's why I kind of stopped the video. So that's who y'all saw who came in, because she had to come in here to cut my pills. But yeah, never give anybody the benefit of the doubt to put you down and to make you feel like you're less than others, because hell no. And the reason I use them two as an example, because those are two artists that I look up to. And like I said, you know, I was fortunate to meet Becky G. I remember meeting her, and I even told her, because man, she has a badass necklace of a taco. Oh, and I told her, man, I told her, Becky G, me and you, we could be best friends, girl, because I love tacos. And she left. She's like, yeah, man. She's like, I love tacos, you know, this and this and that. And, you know, we had a little conversation. That's what I liked about her, because a lot of celebrities usually won't want to make a conversation with you. And this is what I'm telling a lot of people on, like, my TikTok now. It's like, because my numbers are growing on TikTok, man. Right now, unfortunately, I have 514 or 20 fans now. I started off only with 20 something fans, and now I have 500 and something fans, and I'm following them, because I don't want to be like a lot of people, like a lot of these big people that like are celebrities, and they have all these fans following, but they're following zero fans. Like, no, man, if you're gonna show me love, I'm gonna show you love back, and the best of my ability. If I don't message you at the end of the day, I apologize if I don't message you. But at the end of the day, my bad, it's because a guy from work messaged me. He said, "Hope I'm feeling good," but I'm about to reply to him in a minute when I'm done. At the end of the day, you know, it's like, it's thanks to y'all. It's thanks to the viewers for watching me. Because if it wasn't for y'all, I wouldn't be getting any likes. I wouldn't be getting any comments. It's the same thing for my TikTok right now. I've been having a lot of people, you know, they've been, you know, trying to do the collabs with me on TikTok or whatever. And I don't mind. And I've been doing them, but I've been doing them, like, with Celie's Rose. And, like, and people like that, you know. And I've been doing my own thing. And, like, right now, my biggest number on one of my things is almost hitting to 3.something K. And that was, like, one of the ones that I put when I had first had my, when I had my tube, my tubes or whatever. And, you know, that one is one of my biggest, highest rated thing right now. But I have a lot of K's on my TikTok. So I'm like, if these people are taking their time out to view my thing, to view my stuff, to follow me, to become fans of me, because that's what it's called on TikTok. They're fans. They're not called followers. They're actually fans. On my side, it would be following, because I'm following them. But if these people are trying to get me to the top, it would only be benefit of the doubt, to be fair, for me to sit there and give them a follow back. Because I'm not going to be one of them persons like, oh, no, I just want people to be my fans, but I'm not going to follow back. Like, no, I'm not that type of character. If anything, if you're going to follow me, I'm going to follow you back. All I say is just, if you're a female, just have that respect. And, you know what I'm saying? Because I know a lot of females. Trust me, I know a lot of females. I was raised, you know, with my mom, my sister, you know, and, you know, my girl, and all this and that. And, of course, when you're in a relationship, it's not cool for another female to call the dude babe or love or anything like that. I know y'all are probably just doing it because that's how every female lives. Because, like, a lot of females, that's how they call their homeboys or homegirls. Like, hey, it's just like a habit, like, hey, babe, or hey, love. But with all the respect, I just say, you know, just call me by MTZ King and we're Gucci. But that's all I'm asking is just keep it to a respect level, and you know, we're Gucci. And like I say, I'm sorry if I don't get all your response to all your messages, but I really appreciate each and every one of y'all. I try to comment to everybody's comment, but there's some people that even be like, oh, when people start saying beautiful, I'm just like, hey, hold on, wait a minute, calm down, man. Like, hold on, wait, chill out, you know what I'm saying? Stop there. If you want, especially when it's coming from a dude, that's just awkward to me. So I'm just like, hey, hold on, wait, calm down, bruh. call me bruh if you want, bruh. You know, beautiful, like, calm down, you know what I'm saying? you're passing the line right there. No disrespect, but I'm just saying, you know, I'm not used to being called beautiful. It's like, what the hell? I'm used to, you know, my girl telling me I'm handsome or damn, you're fine or sexy, but that's from my girl, you know. And from like my mom, all like, you're cute or this and that, you know. But like from anybody else, it's just really like, what? Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't expect that. Yeah, like I say, you know, just don't let nothing, you know. We're all going to have ups and downs. We're going to have people that are going to turn us down. But at the end of the day, hey, you're going to become somebody and they're going to be like, damn, I should have kept that person because that person would have been making me money. And like I say, you know, I got mad respect for Ariana Grande and Becky G because Becky G, to be a Latina, homegirl doing big things. And Ariana Grande, to be Ariana Grande, homegirl doing big things. Like, shit, if I could really be like, they my homegirls. I'd be like, they my homegirls, you know what I'm saying? Like, that'd be like fam right there, you know what I'm saying to me? That'd be fam right there to me because I have mad respect for them young ladies. Because they're literally, like I said, Becky G just turned 22. Ariana Grande is 25, about to be 26. And yes, I know their birthday. Why? Because I'm a freaking fan of theirs. Like I said, Becky G's birthday was yesterday. Well, yesterday, March the 2nd. Justin Bieber's was the 1st. I used to be Ariana Grande's birthday is June the 26th. And the only reason I actually could remember her birthday is because that's the day my uncle passed away back in 2008. So that's how I could always remember Ariana Grande's birthday. But, you know what I'm saying? I have mad respect for them, like, real talk. And, you know, people talk a lot of shit down on them and be like, oh, they're this or they're that or they're trashy or they're blah, blah, blah. Like, I really don't give a shit what anybody says because I still be bumping and grinding to their music. That's just me, though. Just like, you know, Chris Brown. I'm a huge Chris Brown fan, just like I'm an NF fan. And I'm a fan of Kingdom of Music. I'm a big fan of him. He's a Christian rapper. I'm a big fan of him. I'm a big fan of NF. I'm a huge fan of Chris Brown. I've been a huge fan of Chris Brown since Chris Brown came out. I've been a fan of NF since he came out. Ever since I heard of Kingdom of Music, which was like probably 3 years ago, I've been a fan of him. So, you know what I'm saying? I support, you know, a lot of, you know, guys too, you know. But I'm more kind of like on the on the lovey-dovey type of music, you know what I'm saying? Like, I like, two, Trey Songz kind of music, Usher, Boyz II Men, 112, all these, you know, old school, artists with, you know, R&B and, lovey-dovey type. I'm the lovey-dovey type of dude. That's just me, you know what I'm saying? I'm the type of dude that, for my girl, I'll put rose petals on the thing and put a whole bunch of balloons and light up the damn room with candles. That's just the type of dude I am. Like, I'm a romantic type of dude. It's just me. But I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video up because my phone is actually dying. I need to pop it on a charger. But I appreciate all the love and support from everybody, from TikTok, from YouTube, from Facebook, from Twitter, from Instagram, from Snapchat, from whatever else. From my SoundCloud. Be looking out, because I'm going to have new music dropping out soon, too. And I just appreciate everybody, man. I love each and every one of you. And I have my mad respects for everybody. And like I said, I don't ever want nobody to question me and ask me, why don't you put your girl out here? Why don't you put your kids? Why don't you put your family? At the end of the day, My thing is called MTZ King for a reason, because my family doesn't like to be on my vlogs. My girl, right now I haven't really seen her to put her on my vlogs. I really haven't seen my kids either. So I talk to them, yes. I video with them, yes. But at the end of the day, I can't put that out there because I'm actually using my phone to vlog. So how am I going to vlog and be putting them on there? You know what I mean? But, just respect that right now, but who knows, you know, later on, probably in future videos, they might be in my videos, you know. Usually right now my little brother had been being in my videos, and but yeah, you know what I'm saying, just, you know, bear with me. Like I said, I'm a different vlogger. I vlog about my daily life. I don't sit here and platform, oh yeah, I'm gonna vlog about this, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do this prank, I'm gonna do that. Nah, that's not me. I'm just a regular vlogger that vlogs about my real life, what goes on in my real life, whether it's boring, whether it's adventuring, whether it's fucking boring, whatever it may be. But I hope that I could probably have maybe one cool vlog, maybe during spring break, because spring break is actually coming up and I kind of want to go to the zoo. So probably y'all might catch me at the zoo with my favorite animal. If you know what my favorite animal is, put the emoji. If y'all don't know, that's pretty sad. But I'm sure y'all know what my favorite animal is. But I kind of want to go to the zoo. But if I don't make it to the zoo for spring break, I might try to make it to the zoo during the summertime. So who knows, you know, y'all might get one cool vlog where I'm not just in my room. But right now, literally every vlog's been in my room, because I literally just been chilling at home since I had surgery. And like I said, I went out with my parents today, but I was just trying to enjoy that for the moment. So yeah, but with that being said, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, join the fan, join the gang, join your boy MTZ King. And much love and much respect to everybody, and may God bless each and every one of y'all. And never give up on your dreams. And shout out to everybody who has cancer and everybody who's fighting diabetes. Whatever you're fighting, and if you're fighting AIDS, whatever you're fighting, man, my heart's with y'all. May God be with y'all. May God cure y'all. Everybody who has any kind of disease, may God be with y'all. And I pray for y'all, even though I don't know y'all, but I send blessings your way. And may God cure y'all and be with y'all through thick, through thin. But remember, always put up a fight, never give up. With that being said, I'm out. Chill.